Harry spun faster and faster, elbows stuck tightly to his sides, blurred fireplaces flashing past him, until he started to feel sick and closed his eyes. Then, when at last he felt himself slowing down, he threw out his hands and came to a halt in time to prevent himself from falling face forward out of the Weasley's kitchen fire. "Did he eat it?" said Fred excitedly, holding out a hand to pull Harry to his feet. "Yes," said Harry, straightening up. "What was it?" "Tonton toffee," said Fred brightly. "George and I invented them, and we've been looking for someone to tell them on all summer." The tiny kitchen exploded with laughter. Harry looked around and saw that Ron and George were sitting at the scrapped wooden table with two red-haired people Harry had never seen before, though he knew immediately who they must be: Bill and Charlie, the two eldest Weasley brothers.
"How are you doing, Harry?" says the nearer of the two, dreaded at heel, holding out a large hand, which Harry shook, feeling calluses and blister under his fingers. This had to be Charlie, who worked with dragons in Romania. Charlie was a bit like the twins, short and stockyed, the Persian Ron, who were both long and lanky. He had a broad, good-natured face, which was weather-beaten and so freckly that he looked almost dead. His arm were muscly, and one of them had a large, shiny burn on it. Bill got to his feet, smiling, and also shook Harry's hand. Bill came as something of a surprise.
Harry knew that he worked for the Wizarding Bank, Gringotts, that he had been head boy of Hogwarts, and had always imagined Bill to be an older version of Percy. Fussy about rule breaking and fond of bossing everyone around. However, Bill was, there was no other word for it, cool. He was tall, with long hair that he had tied back in a ponytail. He was wearing an earring with what looked like a fang dangling from it. His clothes would not have looked out of place at a rock concert, except that Harry recognized his boots to be made, and not of leather, but of dragon hide.
Before any of them could say anything else, there was a faint opposing noise, and Mr. Weasley appeared out of thin air at George's shoulder. He was looking angrier than Harry had ever seen him. "That wasn't funny, Fred," he shot. "What on earth did you give that maggot boy?"
"I didn't give him anything," said Fred with another evil grin. "I just dropped it. It was his fault he went and ate it. I never told him to."
"You dropped it on purpose," roared Mr. Weasley. "You know he'd eat it. You know he was on a diet."
"How big did his tongue get?" George asked eagerly.
"It was 4 foot long before his parents would let me shrink it."
Harry and the Weasleys roared with laughter again.
"It isn't funny," Mr. Weasley shot. "That sort of behavior seriously undermines Wizard Muggle relations. I spent half my life campaigning against the mistreatment of Muggles and my own sons."
"We didn't give it to him because he was a Muggle," said Fred ingenuously.
"No, we gave it to him because he's a great bullying git," said George.
"Isn't he, Harry?"
"Yeah, he is, Mr. Weasley," said Harry earnestly.
"That's not the point," raged Mr. Weasley. "You wait until I tell your mother."
"Tell me what?" said a voice behind them. Mrs. Weasley had just entered the kitchen. She was a short, plump woman with a very kind face. Strong, her eyes were presently narrowed with suspicion.
"Oh, hello, Harry dear,"
she said, spotting him and smiling. Then her eyes snapped back to her husband. Tell me what, Arthur?
Mr. Weasley hesitated. Harry could tell again, however angry he was with Fred and George. He hadn't really intended to tell Mrs. Weasley what had happened. There was a silence while Mr. Weasley eyed his wife nervously. Then two girls appeared in the kitchen doorway behind Mrs. Weasley, one with very bushy brown hair and rather large front teeth. Was Harry and Ron's friend Hermione Granger. The other, who was small and red-haired, was Ron's younger sister Ginny. Both of them smiled at Harry, who grinned back, which made Ginny go scarlet. She had been very taken with Harry ever since his first visit to the Barrow.
Tell me what, Arthur, Mrs. Weasley repeated in a dangerous sort of voice. It's nothing, Molly, mumbled Mr. Weasley. Fred and George just, but I've heard what's with them. What have they done this time? Said Mrs. Weasley. If it's got anything to do with Weasley's wizard wizards. Why don't you show Harry where he's sleeping, Ron? Said Hermione from the doorway. He knows where he's sleeping, said Ron. In my room, he slept there last. We can all go, said Hermione pointedly. Oh, said Ron, turning on. Right, yeah, we'll come too, said George. You stay where you are, snarled Mrs. Weasley. Harry and Ron edged out of the kitchen and said, Hermione and Ginny set off along the narrow hallway and up the rickety staircase that zigzagged through the house to the upper stories. What are Weasley wizard wizards? Harry asked as they climbed.